All right, as promised, this is Applications of Percents Part 2 by Professor G. And so now we're going to look at some different types of problems, but we're still going to use the same formula, right? So here we go. A problem that I found was, according to USA Today, girls make up 60% of the horror movie audience if 423 people attend a showing of The Ring, which is a horror movie. How many are expected to be girls? Right? I mean, this is a reasonable question if you're doing demographic data, if you're doing collecting sociological data, because girls buy different stuff, they go to different things. So if 60% are girls and 423 people go, how many are expected to be girls? Well, the idea, again, remember, our formula is the percent of the whole is the part, right? So the percent is 60%, and we're going to convert that to a decimal, so 6/10 or 60/100. Of gets translated as a multiplication. The whole amount, 423 people went, so 423 people is the whole amount, is, it gets translated as equal sign, the part, right? And what part are we looking for? The part that are girls, okay? And I have three girls, so this is interesting to me, right? Now, this is just an order of operation problem. The girls is already solved for. So I'm just going to multiply 60 hundredths times 423. And with a quick calculation, we get 253.8 girls. In part one, I mentioned that we should always think about the physical situation, right? Have you ever seen 8/10 of a girl running around? I mean, this is not true. You can't buy 8/10 of a movie ticket. And so what you should do is round this up. And so this would be 254 girls can be expected to attend the movie. Now, even if this was 253.2, you can't sell 0.2 of a ticket, so even in that case, you would round up, alright? So note that really, any part gets rounded up, okay? Because you got to get to that next value that makes it true, and you got to buy a whole thing, a whole ticket, a whole door, you know, a whole truck, you know, and so you pretty much have to round just any part up, okay? So that is the first one. Now, the next one that we want to look at is a communication arts magazine. So a communication arts magazine is sold to students for 68% of the regular price, right? If the student rate is $32, what is the regular rate? So again, we're looking at the percent of the whole is the part. And here the idea is that 68% is our discount, is how much we're gonna pay of the total, right? Of the regular subscription rate, Well, I don't know what the regular subscription rate is, but that would be the whole amount without the discount. If I paid full price, that would be the regular price. Is the student price of $32. Okay, so you go, oh yeah. So $32 is part of the whole amount. The whole amount is what we're looking for. And the amount that I pay is 68%. So those three pieces are in the exact right spot. And now we are going to divide, because the inverse of multiply is to divide. And so I'm going to divide by the 0.68, divide by 0.68. And so the regular subscription price is $47.05. And then there's some numbers left over, right? So this is a big thing. Now again, note that you want to make this fit reality. Okay? And so in reality, all of this part over here is less than a penny. And we don't have anything that's less than a penny. So we're going to round up and say that it's $47.06 is the regular price of this Communication Arts magazine. So always be thinking. It's one of our core values. You gotta really do it in math. Think, value, act, communicate. Think about what a reasonable answer is. What also makes this reasonable is that it's larger than the $32. If I had gotten something that was less than $32, I would be like, what happened there? You know, so always think about these things and don't get taken by surprise. Alright, so now let's look at the third type of problem. The National Osteoporosis, and I'm going to really abbreviate this, Foundation, reports that 2,300,000 men and how many? 7,800,000 women suffer from osteoporosis. All right, so what percentage are women? Okay, so what percentage are women? Now, this is a great question, right? So you know the number of men, you know the number of women, but sometimes because populations increase over time, you want to look at percentages. Is the percent increasing? Is the percent decreasing? Is there a there are slightly more women than men in the American population right now. Is this statistically more than the average number of women? And of course you can look at the numbers and tell, right? Because you're looking at basically 10 million people and almost 8 million of them are women. Okay, so let's plug this into our formula and see what's going to happen, right? So the percent of the whole is the part. Well, this gets us our first problem, right? Because the percent is what we're looking for, but I want the whole amount. Well, I don't have the whole amount. I have men and I have women, but all people would be the whole amount. So I have to add those two things together. And when I add those together, I get 10,100,000 people with osteoporosis in the country. And that is, what part am I looking for? Well, the part that I'm looking for is women. And so I'm only going to look at the 7,800,000 figure. Okay? And now this is, again, is a multiply. This is our equation. I'm looking for a percent. And the percentage is really part of the whole. So it makes sense that I go ahead and divide, because the inverse of multiplication is division. And a percentage is a part of the whole. And so the division here makes perfect sense. Now, I am going to help you out with this and simplify this a little bit, right? Look at all these zeros, right? You got one, two, three, four, five zeros that are the same on the top and the bottom. And so you can reduce this problem to 78 over 101. All right, so out of 101 osteoporosis cases, you would expect 78 of them to be women. And so as a decimal, this is going to be 0.772. And actually, this is repeating, right? It's 7722, 7722, 7722. So I could put a bar over this whole four-digit number, right? Now, how do I want to write this? Okay. Well, probably this is a decimal. So remember, I got to convert this to a percent. So the percentage is going to be equal to 77.22. That would be to the nearest hundredth. You could write it as 77.2. That would be to the nearest tenth. You could write it as just 77%. That would be to the nearest whole number. So this is to the nearest hundredth. This one would be to the nearest tenth. And then this would be just to the nearest whole percentage, right? And it could ask for either one of those three. It did not specify on the problem, so I'm guessing that a teacher would have to take any of those three answers. But usually on a test or something, you'd want to be specific and do that. So there you go. So hopefully you have enjoyed this, and it's helped you kind of be able to do some more of these problems. And have a great day.